Hey guys, so welcome to your general reading for Capricorn. What lessons do you need to learn for December 2022? You could apply this to any replacement. So we're going to take a look and see what lessons you guys need to learn, and then we'll finish off the read to see what advice we have for you, what else you need to know, look out for, work on, apply this to your own unique situation. Keep in mind that these are general messages. Take what resonates and leave the rest behind. If this message didn't resonate with you, take a look at your other placements. If you guys haven't done so yet, hit the subscription button and the notification bell so that you guys get notified on when my new videos post. Give this video a thumbs up, like this video, share this video, leave a comment down in the comment section below if this message resonates. Keep in mind that these are collective messages for the collective Capricorn people, not tapping into one specific person's energies in particular. If you're looking for a reading tailored to your specific unique situations and your energies, I suggest you book a private personal reading with me. The link for that is in the description box below. All right, so tell me about Capricorn here. What lessons does Capricorn need to learn? What lessons does Capricorn need to learn for December 2022 for Capricorn? Oh, keep in mind that this reading is not really meant to be cross-watched, twisted, flipped, or reversed, okay? This is more so for the Capricorn individuals that are currently in a path of healing, personal growth, and spiritual growth. But if you want to do that, you can feel free to do so. Eight of Swords and a Seven of Wands. You know, I feel like Capricorn, I feel like you have a fear of opening yourself to other people. There's also a bit of resistance here, okay? You know, there's also... there's definitely fear here. I don't know. There's a fear of like maybe standing up for yourself, or maybe fear of like having boundaries here with people. Okay, we have the Page of Swords and the Devil here. So Page of Swords, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, and the Devil, Capricorn energy. We have the Hermit here, Virgo energy, and the Ace of Swords. You know, I do feel like there is some deep-seated fears about speaking some sort of truth here, okay? So there's an energy of like feeling like, okay, I'm uncomfortable, you know, I don't agree with this, or I don't want to do this, but there's an energy of just sort of doing it, even though you're uncomfortable, okay? So, you know, I do feel like with the Hermit here, you know, I do feel like there's a sense of needing to do some deep inner work here. There's an energy of definitely having a hard time standing up for yourself, for having boundaries here with people, because I do feel like people could take advantage of you very, very, very easily. Eight of Swords. We have the Lovers here. Seven of Wands and the Queen of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. This is so interesting. Capricorn, you're extremely guarded, but you fear that you won't find love and that you want to find love. Queen of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. One of the things I'm getting here is that I feel like you just give too much too soon too. This is so interesting. There's a bit of contradiction here. You know, I do feel like sometimes that as people, we are a book of contradictions, you know. Really depends on the person's situation here. But yeah, this is really interesting. The Lovers, Gemini energy, Queen of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Six of Wands, and the Page of Swords, the Devil here, and the Six of Pentacles. This is so interesting. I feel like the ego is getting in the way here. There's also a lack of like, you know, this is so interesting. This might resonate with like one of you guys, but there's a energy of definitely having a hard time having discussions where there's a difference in opinions. Yeah, there's a lack of accepting other people's opinions, or you know worldviews or something like that, things like that. There's difficulty having conversations in that, because I just feel like someone here is just really stuck in their own ways here, or that someone here sees things as their own way, but there's like no flexibility, there's no bending. You know, this way is the best, you know, other people's ways are not the best. Tell me about the Hermit here. We have the Page of Pentacles, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, Ace of Swords here, and the Wheel of Fortune. You know, I just feel like this is actually really, this is, I do feel like this is like self-inflicting karma here, and I feel like someone here has a pattern of doing this. I mean, like I said, you could apply this to your own unique situation. This reading is not really meant to be cross-watched, but if you want to, you could do so. Tell me about Capricorn here. What else is tell me what advice we have here for Capricorn. What does Capricorn need to look out for and work on here for December 2022 for Capricorn? We have the Five of Cups and the Ten of Cups. You know, I do feel like someone here, I don't know, someone here could be in this like really pessimistic energy. It's sort of like one of those energies of like, you know, things can be going extremely, extremely well, but someone here has to look for a problem. Yeah. We have the Four of Pentacles here and Judgment, Sagittarius energy. And then we have the Knight of Wands and the Nine of Wands. I do feel like someone here runs away from their problems, runs away from their trauma and their pain here. And I feel like what the Judgment card and the Wheel of Fortune being here, I feel like the universe is trying to wake somebody up. You know, it's sort of like one of those things that things are not as bad as it seems, because I feel like someone here is creating that for themselves. Like I said, I feel like there's an energy of like, you know, things can be going really, really well, but someone here is looking for problems, you know? The Five of Cups. We have the Ace of Pentacles here. Tell me about the Ten of Cups. And the Tower here, Aries, Scorpio energy. Yeah, I just feel like there's a bit of pessimism here. I mean, there's an energy of definitely looking for, you know, or creating a mountain out of a molehill. Is that how you say it? Yeah, it's just an energy of creating problems when there are no problems there. Four of Cups and the Knight of Swords, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini, the Knight of Wands here, and the Page of Wands, the Knight, Nine of Wands. And the King of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. There's an energy of definitely avoiding trauma and pain here. There's definitely an energy of resisting and acceptance here. Yeah, there's an energy of definitely like also looking for love, but also being closed off to it. I mean, this has something to do with the universe is stepping in for some sort of divine intervention with you, because, you know, with the Devil here, I do feel like that energy needs to be moved. Yeah, it's kind of like, you know, energy of like, I'm looking for happiness, I'm looking for, you know, bliss, but you know, there's an energy of like looking for problems, you know. So yeah, so Capricorn, I hope that this was helpful. I hope that this resonated. If it did, leave a comment down in the comment section below. Share this video, like this video if you haven't done so yet. Subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I will speak to you guys in the next one. All right, thanks guys, bye.